I saw a really cool sub that you did on a guy, a go-go bada.
Yeah, well, you should just put that on everybody that didn't know how to...
I was like, what is that?
That didn't know how to defend against it. So you got really common and class to, for everybody that didn't see that coming.
So that's like a shin against the throat, right?
It's just you can go the wrong direction. Or you're forced in the wrong direction. You should be going the other direction. And once you go too far into something, you can't really come back.
Who was...
Best way to not get put in, to get out of stuff, is to not get put in it.
You fought anyone, anytime, any weight class. What was your toughest fight, whether they were on steroids or not?
Probably Jeremy Jackson.
Why?
Well, it was just a, hell, I couldn't get the guy out of my life. I fought him 3 times. And then the first time I was at the end of the night, where I fought twice. That's how long I've been fighting. I've been fighting back from the day when they still had, like, sometimes you can fight more than one time in the night.
You know.
This promoter had this King of the Mountain show, and I fought 3 times, and I was 18 years old fighting 3 times in one night.
You know, boxing.
I had all the hard fights. These guys walking through people, knocking them out one hit. And I'm doing 3 rounds with the first guy, 3 rounds with the second guy. And then I'm getting drilled in the last round.
Big boxers fight once or twice a year. Can you imagine if they fought 3 times in one night?
Yeah, that's wild. I know, it's never even heard of or thought of. I don't even thought of that, of doing something like that. Kickboxing, yeah. Three-minute rounds.
When you broke Joe Hurley's arm, what did you whisper to him afterwards?
I'm sorry.
But were you sorry?
Yeah, I felt bad for that.
You know it's a long road to recovery.
Why take it serious? You know, take it serious. It's like, yeah, I'm
sorry. He could do that to you? I mean, not that he would. But
you know what he told me? He told me that Nick said, "I heard you don't tap." That's what he said. He was a bar back at the B-side bar.
Yeah, I heard all kinds of stuff about him. I've watched him fight. That's what I'm saying. Like, people don't understand. Like, I was a fanatical fan. I used to go watch Stevie fight at Hill on the Ceiling Fox, Trick It Up. And this fool would fight, you know, earlier in the night. And he'd not come out in, like, these army shorts, cutoffs. And and he'd fight, he'd knock someone out. Knock somebody out. You hear the punch, and you hear the guy go bam, hit the ground. And then everybody go like, yeah, Hurley, Hurley, Hurley. Everybody's chanting Hurley. And then 3 years later, I was 16, 3 years later, 3 or 4 years later, I'm fighting him. About 4 years later, I'm fighting this guy. So I'm fighting the guy. 4 years before this, he's like my fucking hero. So I had that over and over again. Like, Cormier is like, I was watching this thing, Cormier last night, he's fighting, you know, I'm like, that's similar, like, in my career, like, when I fought, like, Frank Shamrock. It's like, somewhere back in the day when I fought, like, talking right now here, Frank Shamrock. I'm like, I did a lot of fights, and they might have a lot of fights on their record, but look how easy he could take down, like, the matchups and fighters and the level of skill. Usually a lot of those guys, his size and his way, they learn from guys. At heavyweight, they learn from guys his size, and at light heavyweight, they learn from guys my size and lower.
Nick.
Guys don't start out, you know, expert jiu-jitsu guys at 200 pounds.
Back. 'Cause it's Elie Seckbach.